Hi, I'm Ben Helms, and I'd like to welcome you to Salt City Center. Tonight's performance of William Mastro Simone's play, Extremities. First of all, I'd like to very briefly go over with you the upcoming season. Then I'd like to discuss the play with you for a short bit. It's a play that needs a little discussion. The upcoming season is excellent, every bit as good as last season. Extremities will be closing next weekend, and opening in the main theater on October 26th, in the main theater, will be the Salt City production of the Broadway blockbuster 42nd Street. Now, this will be starring Bob Brown, and we have a New York City actor choreographer by the name of Keith Rosser as the director. Keith is wonderful. I have a little part in the show, and Keith is terrific. I'm rehearsing over in the main theater right now. I should be there, but terrific show. A lot of tap dancing, excellent music, Shuffle Off to Buffalo, all kinds of familiar songs. So that'll be opening October 26th in the main theater. Opening on December 7th will be the Christmas offering this year. It's a show called She Loves Me. It's written by the same people who wrote Fiddler on the Roof. Supposedly an excellent, excellent show. Fine Christmas type show. I don't know the show myself. I'd tell you about it if I knew it, but I don't. But I understand it is a very, very nice, heartwarming show. That'll be opening December 7th. Opening on January 18th here in this room, this theater, is a show that I saw several years ago on Broadway, and I remember it yet. It's a chilling, chilling, scary show called Child's Play. It's a gothic horror. It takes place in a Catholic boys' school where satanic type things start happening. I won't tell you what they are, but you won't forget them when you see them. It opens on January 18th here. It'll be directed by Bob Fitzsimmons from New York City, who brought us such shows here at Salt City as last year's La Caja Fall, Death of a Salesman, Harvey, one of the really great shows here. That'll be opening on January 18th. Opening on March 1st, we'll bring you the third part of the Neil Simon trilogy, Broadway Bound. 2 years ago, we brought you Brighton Beach Memoirs. Last year was Biloxi Blues. This year is the third and last part of the trilogy, Broadway Bound, where Neil Simon, in the guise of Eugene Morris Jerome, for those of you who have followed the trilogy along, leaves home and heads to New York for the big time. Funny show. That'll be opening on March 1st. April 19th will be a political comedy called A Walk in the Woods. It was on Broadway a couple years ago. Now, if any of you are ticket holders or devotees of Syracuse Stage, you know, you've been reading in the paper that Arthur Storch will be directing Anthony Quinn in a production of A Walk in the Woods at Syracuse Stage, I believe, in November. Of course, our Walk in the Woods was planned a lot longer ago than theirs was. So what we thought we would do is invite Mr. Storch and Mr. Quinn back here in April to see Joe Latito and John Sievers do the roles and show them how it should have been done to begin with. So that may work out. I don't know. That'll be opening on April 19th. And closing out the regular season in the main theater will be a delightful musical called Once Upon a Mattress. It's the musical version of A Princess and the Pea. This is the show that catapulted Carol Burnett into stardom. Terrific show, and we've been very fortunate in being able to obtain all of the costumes and all of the sets from the Lake George Opera Company's presentation of the show. And of course, they're an equity company. They're a wonderful company. It's going to be a really colorful, wonderful show. It'll close out the main season on May 3rd. And of course, the 13th annual production of Jesus Christ Superstar. And again, we're happy to announce that Bob Brown will once again star in the title role. That will be opening on March 8th, and it will run all through Lent. If you've seen it before, Superstar, for heaven's sakes, come back, see it again. It's going to be a little different this year, just like it was last year. It was a little different again. If you haven't seen it at all, the previous 12 offerings, come, because it is something to behold. We have people come from all over the country. We had them from Nova Scotia last year, California, Minnesota. I can't tell you the places that they came from. So come and see Superstar, opening March 8th. Now, extremities. I had the pleasure of assisting Joe Latito in directing the show. It's a two-act show, fairly short. There will be one intermission. It'll be about 20 minutes. The concession stands are going to be open, of course. The show, if you haven't seen it, you haven't heard about it, it's a kind of a shocking show. It's about, as you probably know, a horrible problem that's confronting, certainly around here these past few weeks. It's about rape. God knows you don't pick a paper up without seeing somebody has been raped up the street two blocks away or down the street two blocks. Horrible, horrible problem. This show is very graphic. It's very violent. The language in it is very raw, very, very rough. It may offend you. In fact, I'm sure it will. You may not like it. You may be offended by it, but you're not going to forget it. The acting in it is super. I usually say sit back and relax and watch whatever. Well, you're not going to sit back and relax and watch this, but I think you're going to enjoy Extremities. Thank you.
Thank you. Joe, it's me. Why are you doing? Hey, is Joe in?
There's no Joe here.
You know, we said he'd be in.
No Joe lives here.
Oh.
You always just walk into people's houses?
I'm sorry. Excuse me. I'm really sorry.
It's okay.
You have a good day.
You too.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Hey, you live here?
Good guess.
What, Joe Marote?
Joe who?
Joe, you know, I forget.
There never was any Joe here.
Hey, what is this, all one house or apartments?
All one house.
You know, he said he had a
apparently
room.
Apparently he lied.
Yeah, there's somebody else.
I'm sorry, you have to go.
Hey, can I use your phone, please?
No.
It's a local call.
No, you have to go.
Hey, you ride a bike?
No. I use it to collect dust. There's the door.
Yeah, I know where the door is. You don't have to tell me where the door is. You know, this is a real bitch. The guy owes me a lot of money. He said come over and pick it up.
Well, there's no Joe here.
Are you sure, sweetheart?
Maybe my husband knows. He's upstairs.
Yeah, well, why don't you go ask him, baby?
He's busy right now.
Busy.
Sleeping.
Sleeping?
He's a cop.
No kidding.
And I have to wake him up in 5 minutes for work.
Shh. You may wake him.
You better go now.
Copy. Why don't you go ask him if he knows a guy named Joe?
I told you. He's sleeping.
You know, I dropped Joe off at this house last week.
You have the wrong house.
No. No, it was this house. He's 6'2". That's a triumph. He's got a red beard. He wears cowboy boots. Sure guy.
There's no guy here.
Except the cop.
Honey, will you come down here, please?
Boy, that cop's a sound sleeper.
Honey?
What's the matter with him?
Honey!
You know, just like a cop. Never around when you need him.
Honey!
Honey! Honey! Oh, honey! Hey, what's the matter with him? Maybe he ain't here. Huh? Maybe you're telling me a little lie, huh, pretty mama? Maybe you think I scare easy, huh? Go on, go on. Go for the door. Let's see who's faster. So where are the other two chicks to live here?
Kitchen.
A house full of people. When you howl, nobody comes.
Get out!
You got a lousy bunch of friends.
Get out right now!
Take it easy, lovely. I saw the other two chicks leave this morning. Yeah. Won't a ready car? She won't be home till about 5:30. Four specs. About 6. You know, today's gonna be a triple header.
Get out!
No move.
I'm expecting people anytime now. Anytime.
No kidding. Just like that? Hey, you mind if I stick around for the fun? Huh? You're too sweet to hurt. Oh, you smell pretty. That you're smelling your perfume, huh? Yeah, be nice. You want to take a shower together first? Huh? I'll soak you up real good. Be nice. Give me a little smile, babe. You know, I'm going to fuck you front ways, back ways, sideways, in ways you have never heard of. Is it going to be nice, huh? It's going to be nice.
No.
You know, I want to kiss them all, give them names, and kiss them all goodnight. You know, the first time I saw you, I knew it was going to be beautiful, but I didn't know it was going to be this beautiful. I didn't think anything could be this beautiful.
No.
Not any.
Beautiful.
Don't make your lips tight. You know, they always make your lips tight. Now do it nice. Oh, that's still tight. Kiss me nice. Nice. Smile. Nice. How you doing? Answer me!
What?
How you doing? Say good. Good, now invite me in.
In where?
In your house.
We're already here.
It's a nice place. Say thank you.
Thank you.
Now kiss me and tell me you love me.
Please, don't.
You're going to make me do something ugly.
I love you.
You keep telling me, don't stop.
I love you, I love you, I love you.
I mean, how much?
What?
How much?
How much what?
You're trying to wreck this for me.
I love you.
Fucking bitches always got to make it ugly.
I love you.
Yeah, how much?
A lot.
Yeah, more than what?
I don't understand.
You're going to make me do something ugly.
No. I love you more than anything in the world. I love you.
I love how you say that. Now touch me. All over. Nice. Again. Nicer. Touch my hair. My mouth. My neck. And keep telling me. Don't stop. Come on.
I love you.
Keep touching
me. I love you.
Touch me down there.
I love you. I love you.
Touch me down there.
I love you.
And tell me you want to make love.
I love you.
You're going to make me do something ugly.
Please
again.
Don't think anything you want. I've got jewelry upstairs.
See what you made me do? Now touch me down there. Tell me you want to make love.
I love you.
And what else?
I love
and
you.
And what else?
Make love.
Who?
You.
And who else?
And me.
You want to make love?
Yes.
Say it.
I want to make love.
Say that beautiful again.
I want to make love.
Now scream.
What?
Scream. Oh. Lord. See? Help me here, you puta. It's just me and you, puta. Now say it, my puta.
Puta.
Puta. Puta. Whore. My whore. My puta. Say it.
Puta.
Now say it and smile.
I'm your puta.
You like to tease me, huh?
No.
You like to tease everybody, huh? You know what you need, Puta? You need a couple of slashes. Right here.
No! No!
Here! Stripes to make you a zebra face to scare the shit out of anybody you go teasing. Because you're mine. All mine! Say it!
Yours.
No, undo the belt.
Please, God!
Undo it! This is gonna be beautiful, Puta. You keep telling me, don't stop.
I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you.
You smell so pretty.
I love you.
Did you put perfume on for me?
Yes. I love you.
You see it more and more, Puta.
I love you.
This is too beautiful. See? It doesn't have to be ugly, does it?
No, beautiful. I love you. I love you.
Your perfume makes me drunk. You put it on for me?
Yes.
Just for me?
Just for you.
I'm gonna kill you. over, you bitch! I'll kill you! You know, they gotta let me go. Your Honor, I goes out looking for work because I got laid off at the car wash. And she's as barmouth and goes to ask if there was any work because I got 3 babies to feed. And this crazy lady goes and sprays me with a stuff, Your Honor. Well, Marjorie, go down the road and stop a truck on the highway. You got no bruises, no witnesses, no come up here, snatch. You got nothing, pussy. It's a civilized fucking country, pussy. You don't go tying up innocent people, Marjorie.
How do you know my name?
Oh, man, my rights. I want medical attention. You're going to call my attorney, Paul Meary, the fucking best.
How do you know my name?
And you're alone in the room with the pigs. And tell them what happened. And they say, are you sure, sweetheart? They don't believe no prickies, Marjorie.
Don't say my name.
Little Marjorie gets a little right up in the paper. Daddy's heart condition. It could be real sweet if the old fucker croaks. I'm sipping OJ in some nice clean hospital bed. John with the candy stripers and every freak ghost guy's fucking happy Ed Hunter who read the papers for Hitchcomb pussy. Sniffing out here like a pack of junkyard dogs after a bitchin' heat. Maybe dropping on an ounce for a little wet dick. What's that? What's that, Simon? You call the cops? You ain't got a fucking case. They got a Miranda me and let me go. And one day I come back, find you in some parking lot and carve up that tears and face.
No!
Who the fuck you think you're playing, bitch?
No!
What, for your car?
No, for you.
Hey, I don't even know the car.
And matches.
Oh, Jack, listen, I'm doing some thinking here. I'm ready for the truth. I'm a narco. Yeah, we got some tips or some drugs in this house. Come on, open up. I saw you in my bed. But now I got one for 3 days.
Fire!
Okay, all right. I don't know why I didn't tell you in the beginning because this is it.
Jesus Christ.
I used to work on the pothole crew for the county. One day we went around patching up potholes on the highway in front of your driveway. It was a bitchin' day. It was in the 90s. It was hot. We was working with hot tar, getting thirsty, dizzy, forming busting balls, you know. And someone says, hey, look at this. You come riding down the highway on your bike in your little white shorts. And every time you pedal, you could see what was tan and what wasn't. You had your blouse tied in a knot, and someone shot it off your hair. It was beautiful. And that's it.
So why'd you come here?
I just told you, you was beautiful.
So what?
You know what that does to a man? It was hot. You had that little white shirt. Jesus, we had a deal. I had a milk and berry. You were real buying your shorts. I said, how you doing? You didn't say nothing. You looked at me like I was a dead dog. You pissed me off, so I came back here and fuck you. Hey there. What are you gonna do with me?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Nothing.
You mean you're gonna let me go?
No. Nothing.
I don't get what you're talking.
You will.
When?
You'll see.
What, are you gonna starve me?
Good idea.
You get the chair for that. You better call the cops.
Why should I?
That's what they're there for.
2 days. No food, no water.
Can't do this.
I'm doing it.
Come on, Marjorie. I really think you should get the cops.
Why should I? You said I have no proof to let you go.
No, I was just kidding.
It's too late.
Mother of God, don't let me die like this. Answer me. Talk to me, please. So what are you going to do with my body?
Bury it.
Bury it?
I started a graveyard near the woods for the animals that get killed up on the highway. This time I dig deeper.
Hey, you're tricking me out.
I got a shovel.
Hey, come on, don't shit around here. You know, I got a weak ticker. My wife's 8 months pregnant. She won't let me touch her. I gotta get it every day. I need help. Honest to fucking God, I wanna go straight.
You will straighten a fucking hole.
You ain't got the nuts, cunt.
You say that when you're in the bottom of the hole and the first shovel of dirt hits you in the face.
When the other two chicks, when they come home, they'll stop you.
You think so? One helps me dig the hole, the other helps me drag you out.
Mother,
I wanna hear you scream under the dirt like me under the pillow.
You
and worry. You suck for air and dirt fills your mouth and nose.
Oh, Marjorie, get the cops. I wanna tell them everything. Marjorie, this is it. Marjorie! 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 She's digging a hole. She's digging a hole. She's really digging a hole. Oh, Mother of God. I saw an angel like before. How can you let me die like this?
Oh, the pain. It was wrong.
I just now. And I'm dying to heaven. What do I do this time? What do? I do nothing. Broke the statue. Knocked it over. Broke the virgin just now. I got a beaten locked closet with the spiders. Are you there? I know you're there, Marjorie! Are you there? How can you just sit there and draw between us, huh? How can you do this to me?
Are you all right?
Damn it. Damn.
day. That guy Danny I told you about, he cornered me by the water cooler and said, I'm taking you out to dinner and not taking no for an answer. So, I can't help you guys scrape and paint tonight. Oh, and look, Margie, Speedy, Lovey, Cutie Pie, good friend, can I borrow your red dress? You know the one with the spaghetti straps that slid up the side that you...
There's a man in the fireplace.
Don't be scared. He tried to rape me.
Oh, Mother Mary.
He's been watching us. He knows all about us. When you work, when Pat works, our cars, everything.
Who is he?
Please help me.
What did I say about Pat?
Not to.
And what did you do? And what do you deserve?
Mary and Jesus,
what do you deserve?
Oh, the stairs.
Marjorie! Marjorie, it's over now. We'll get the police. They'll lock him up.
On what charge?
Rape.
There was no rape.
Attempted rape.
Prove it. You can't. So they let him go and he said he'd come back and get me. So it's him or me, choose. Him or me, choose.
I'd rather call the police.
Do it. It would make me feel safe. Then do it.
What do I say?
Whatever makes you feel safe.
The phone's dead.
Animal ripped it out of the wall. I got lucky. You could have come home and found my body.
Don't talk like that.
You try and run, and he catches you by the hair and smothers you up till you're too weak to move.
All right.
And then he toys with you. Makes you beg for breath, makes you undo his belt.
Stop it!
Makes you touch him. All over. His hair, his mouth, between his legs.
Why are you doing this to me?
So it won't happen to you. Terry, if it happened to you, I'd say, Terry, tell me what to do.
Tell me what to do.
Be with me.
I am with you. What can I do?
Help me make him disappear.
Let's wait for Pat.
We don't need her. We only need a shovel.
Shovel?
To dig the hole in the garden.
Hole?
And that's the end of it.
Oh, God.
So it's him or us. Choose. Say him when I open the case right now. He gets you. Don't blame me because you chose him. So say it, him or us. Say it, him or us. Decide. Say it, him or us. Him or us.
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 Good. You just dig the hole. I can do the rest.
Just don't let me see it, all right?
See what?
The blood.
What blood? We drag him out, throw him in the hole, and cover it up.
Oh, God.
Is the world better or worse without him?
I don't want to touch him.
All right. All right, I can drag him out myself. You just dig the hole. Dig between the tomatoes and the flower bed. The ground's soft there.
I'd rather you dig.
Okay, then you watch.
I'd rather you watch.
Well, I can't do both!
You dig.
And watch him. And don't leave this room.
Marjorie!
Let's think about this some more.
What's to think about? It's him or you. Choose.
Terrible and begged you to open the cage. Terry says nothing.
in his honor hit you with quilt one, and you go on the Iron Hyatt, the wall. You can open us up with that. Okay, asshole. You ride with Wacko, the wall. You ever hear my attorney? Huh? Palmieri?
Yes.
The fucking best, right? For $2,000, the man walks on water, so you think about a jailbird. Come on, Terry, you don't want a record? Okay, then. Palmieri, complicity in the wall! Can I have a little swig of that, please? I'm parched from screaming. Okay, asshole. Oh, what are you gonna say at confession this week, huh, Terry? Bless me, Father Frierson, I buried the good humor man. Ain't going over too big, Terry. What do you think Father's gonna say, huh? Say three Hail Marys and don't do it again? The fucker will break out the handcuffs on the spot. Hey, but I understand. Really, I do, I understand. You're doing it for Marjorie, right? Good friend, Marjorie.
Will you just shut up?
I would, Marjorie, huh? Friends to the end, huh? She borrows her dress. She borrows your boyfriend. Tony.
What?
Hey, forget it.
No. What did you say?
Oh, you want something from me now, huh? When I ask you for a little something to drink, you give me a cup of dust? And get lost here in your fucking drink.
You're a goddamn liar.
Oh, am I? Am I?
What did she say?
Hey, don't believe me. I'm a liar. Go believe your good friend out there digging a hole. She's real nice. She buries people.
What did she tell you?
Hey, look. I don't like to be the one to bring on the bad news, you know? But she's fucking old.
He doesn't even live around here anymore.
New York? Photographer? Oh, she goes to visit him every Wednesday. You drop her off at the train station? Think about it, Terry. Did she get raped? Huh? Did she got any bruises? I pinched her ass. She took a freaking mangle on me. Did you ever get your ass pinched, Terry? Of course you did. Did you mangle the guy? Of course not. Think, sweetheart. Think.
Tell me everything she said.
Just wet my lips a little bit, please.
All right.
Oh. Oh. Thank you so much. Thank you. It's very kind of you. Very nice. Thank you so much, Terry. You know, I want to light a candle for you. Screaming, I bite your hand the fuck off!
Please don't hurt me!
Yeah, I'm a dead-type person, babe. I'm doing a lot! Jesus, you fucking asshole! You fucked yourself real good, Terry. You know what I mean? You're lying on the wall.
What happened?
Marjorie, I'm sorry. She gave me a little drink of wine.
But I did not!
How'd the wine glass get in here?
God damn it!
You don't.
away. Honest. It's gonna be all right. Honest. We'll take care of everything, okay? You relax. Come over here and lie down. There, okay? Here's a nice pillow.
No!
Okay! Everything's fine. Terry, would you call?
Phone's dead.
Okay, would you get the police?
What do I say?
Tell them to come quickly.
What do we say about him?
Tell them to come and take him away.
No! I mean, if they see him like that, she's in trouble.
What kind of trouble?
Big trouble.
That's right, AMB! ADNW!
Is that true?
We'll get a lawyer.
Lawyer?
You have to, Marge, for your protection.
They'll crucify you.
Terry, please.
I think we should get a lawyer before we get the police.
You don't need a lawyer. The state prosecutes. You're only a witness.
I want a lawyer.
Okay.
Look in the phone book under Pete for Palmieri.
Holy shit.
What?
That's his lawyer.
How do you know?
He told me.
You talked with him.
We'll take care of everything.
I think we should make up a story.
What?
I'll say I was with Marjorie when he broke in.
That's perjury.
If it comes to his word against hers, he wins.
We tell the truth. Now, will you please hurry?
You know his lawyer's gonna file countercharges and haul her downtown.
Is that true?
It's just a formality.
That's all. But bring a toothbrush.
Don't worry about jail.
Jail?
Listen. Me and Marjorie are watching TV. Animal breaks in. There's a struggle. We hog time. He resists, so we throw him in the fireplace and then go for the police.
Police.
Charges. Arraignment, lawyers, time, money, judge, jury. His word against mine. Defendant's attorney. A three-piece button-down, fresh from Harvard, summa cum laude fuck-off. Did my client rape you? No. Assault you? Yes. How? With a pillow. Did you resist?
Yes.
Evidence? None. Witnesses? None. Did you tie him up? Beat him? Lock him in a fireplace? 6 months for me and that animal goes free. And then if I survive being locked up, then what do I do? Come home and lock myself up. Chain lock, boat lock, deadlock. And wait for it. Hear him on every creak of wood. Every mouse in the wall. Every twig tapping on the window. 4 a.m. Start from sleep. See something in the dark at the foot of my bed. Eyes, black holes. Skin speckled gray like a slug. Hit the lights. He's not there. This time. So then what do I do? Wait for him? Or move 3,000 miles? Change my name? Unless my phone get a dog? I don't want to taste my vomit every time the doorbell rings. I don't want to flinch when a man touches me. And I won't wear a goddamn whistle. I just want to live my life. He is never leaving this house.
Marjorie! I think you're in shock and don't know what you're saying. I'm going to a phone booth and call the police, and everything is going to be all right.
I'm not in shock. And more than ever, I know exactly what I'm saying. And you're not going anywhere.
My keys, please.
No.
Then I guess we'll have to walk.
You leave this house and animal dies.
Oh, Marjorie, you don't really mean that.
Please, Serena, don't leave me alone, please.
From now on, I make my own law.
Oh, Mother God.
Thank you. Until I get rid of him. Do you understand?
Your wish, Ayatollah. Wine. So what'd you do in the city yesterday?
Okay, let's just eat now. Sandwich,
roast beef, dry.
Somebody didn't seal it properly. I can't eat with him in there.
Yeah, I am. I'm not.
Let me remind
whether he's a human being like you or me.
Hey, look, don't include me in any of your social theories you learned from a book.
I wouldn't think of going over your head.
So what's your analysis? Is it his childhood, his environment, his Greek dramas? Let's hear the dime store psychiatrist explain this sick creep animal fuck.
Exactly who is the animal here is not entirely clear to me.
Is this clear? Don't mess with the animals.
Nobody dies in my house.
Excuse me.
Shut your face, animal.
Can I say something to Patty, please?
Don't you dare call anyone's name as if you knew us.
What do you want?
Me?
Yes. What's your name?
No. Say it, animal, and I'll smash your head.
Why can't
you? Because if I hear it, I'll put him under.
Okay. What did you want to tell me?
Can I have a little something to drink, please?
No.
My throat. I feel sick.
What kind of sick?
Oh, bad sick. I got a headache. I'm dizzy. She sprayed me with the stuff in my eyes.
What stuff?
In my mouth. I'm holding my vomit because I don't want to, you know, mess up your place or anything.
Harmful or fatal to swallow. Harmful if inhaled or absorbed through skin. Get immediate medical attention. Atropine is antidotal.
Hey, what's that mean?
Do not spray toward face. Avoid breathing spray mist. Do not apply to humans, pets, dishes, or utensils. Keep out of reach of children. What's wrong?
Nothing.
Then why are you gagging?
I don't know. I feel like I absorbed something through my skin.
I would like to go to the drugstore and get the atropine.
No,
this stuff could be fatal.
No!
Then what exactly are your intentions?
What?
What are you going to do with him?
I don't know.
Okay, you don't know. Thank you for being honest.
Hey, look, I'm not one of your fucking social work cases.
Okay.
So don't come off with the superior bullshit.
Okay.
And don't run your routine over
okay,
me.
Okay, relax.
I don't want to relax.
Okay, then we've established you don't want to relax and you've admitted you don't know your intentions.
I didn't admit it. I said it.
Okay, you said it.
I didn't admit it like it was a crime. I said it.
Okay, it was a poor choice of words on my part. I'll be more careful. Now, how do you feel about your situation?
Wonderful. I think it should happen to everyone.
Sarcasm won't help assess the reality of the problem.
What reality?
And the reality is a man is hurt and you don't have a case.
That's why I have a hammer.
Okay, you have a hammer. Let's talk about the hammer.
Hammer. My favorite subject. One good swing can do more than judge, jury, and prosecutor.
Jeez, hey! Let's define our terms. What do you want from him?
A confession.
Good.
In front of you both.
Excellent.
What happened today, fact for fact?
Okay, then something solid.
Hey, I didn't do nothing.
This is your chance to save yourself.
I didn't do nothing, Patty.
She's giving you a chance.
Chance for what? Go to the wall for a bit I didn't pull.
You tell them what you did to me.
Hey, look at her, look at me. Who did what to who?
Tell them, please.
I demand my rights. I want medical attention. I want to call my attorney.
Tell them how you smothered me.
This lady's got laws, Jack, and nobody's above the law.
You made me touch you. You
do something.
Tell them, please. Let's end this.
No innocent person's got nothing to fear in this country. I demand my fucking rights. Oh, Jesus.
You knew what it was like under the pillow, sucking for breath that wasn't there.
Tell me. Talk about the pillow.
Talk. Hell, I'll show you.
Get the hell away from me with that thing.
This is not a thing. This is a pillow. Let's define our terms.
It'll all come out in court.
One Italy woman in court has to be dead on arrival.
You are not the law. You are not God. You have to bring it to court.
We can't just keep him like a pet.
Why don't you shut the hell up?
Yeah, you're interrupting Bridges' routine.
I hope we can rise above this personal bullshit.
It's very personal. It's between him and me, so keep out of it.
When will you be satisfied? Will you become like him?
Like him. I crave to be like him. No mind. No care. Nothing human holding back the impulse to strike, tear, slash, and reduce to splinters of bone. Oh, God, make me more like him. Don't stare at me. Forgive me for surviving. Maybe you'd care more if you came home and tripped over my body and found animal waiting for you. What's going on here? Don't I count? What about me? Don't I count?
I'm sorry. If we have to take off tomorrow, we take off. We're going to do the best thing for Marjorie.
You're gonna burn. 1, 2, 3, burn!
Okay, let's relax. Wine. Oh, I forgot. Okay, now I'm sure the three of us can come up with something positive.
This has nothing to do with me.
I can understand how you feel.
No, you can't. Only I understand how I feel.
Okay, I can relate to that.
And I am not taking off tomorrow because you're not worth it.
Okay, Terry seems to feel ill. Okay, let's look at the facts. We got a man here. He's tied up. He's injured. What does this mean?
God, I can't think today.
Okay, the problem is this. What laws are violated? Do we all agree on what the problem is? Okay, let's stick with the facts. Do you have any bruises?
He bit me.
Wonderful. I mean, you know, for court, it shows.
Yeah, I bit him. He just choked me with a wire!
Did you put anything on it?
Peroxide.
Okay, what's with your leg?
I get stung by a wasp. That's all right.
Okay? Facts. There was an attempted rape, but you can't prove that. And then there was torture. You can prove that. Torture. You can't do that, but you did it.
They'll throw the key away.
Shut up, idiot! I'm sorry. I appreciate your opinions, but they do not throw keys away. They have suspended sentence, plea bargaining, parole, probation. They have a lot of things. Okay, we've isolated the problem. I don't know what to do. But I do know your lives are joined now. If he goes under, so do you. If he's kept well, so are you. And that's all I care about, you. Use the hammer or don't use the hammer. At the moment, you have a choice. But if he dies, and he could be dying right now, you have no more choice, and neither do I. So giving him a little bread to absorb the poison in his mouth will be one very powerful witness of your humanity. And you need all you can get. One roll. Half a roll. For you.
Do it.
Thank you.
Hey, that goes for me too. Can I have a little sip of wine, please?
No!
It's just the same.
If I hear that voice again, I'll tear him to pieces.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, pieces.
Will you shut up, please?
Whatever you think's best, honey.
I have bread for you.
Would you feed me, please? My hand's broken.
Don't put your hand in there.
Why not? What could he do?
He said he'd bite my hand off.
I thought this had nothing to do with you.
Kiss off. Okay.
Hey, your ass.
Marjorie, do you think we could unlock it?
No.
Careful.
No.
This bread's for you, not him.
No.
If and when I'm asked what I saw here, I truthfully don't know what I could say in your favor.
That's good to know.
Open it, goddammit! I'm not going to prison for you!
Prison?
You? Never! You do exactly what good little girls are supposed to do. Nothing. You didn't get raped, so don't tell me you can do something. Because you can't. Because I know. Because I've got raped.
And it was all my fault. Because I dressed up like Tinkerbell. Pink tights, one size too small. Half shot in the ass on barren grass. My best girlfriend's father offered me a ride home. He took a shortcut through the cemetery and stopped behind this mausoleum. So what could I do? Tell? Ruin everybody? Lord. You can't undo it. It's over. I lived. Besides, you know what they say. I asked for it. So I went to bed that night and pretended like it was all just a bad dream. But you didn't even get raped. And I'm not committing complicity for you.
Open it.
Thank you. What's the combination?
931 left 40.
And the last number?
I'll do it.
Thank you.
juice he won't be able to swallow.
Do it.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
There.
Thanks a lot.
Open up. Let me feed you.
Hey, it's good bread. Good bread. And so good with butter.
You buttered it just a little.
Good bread. Hey, where do you get bread like this? You know, I had to pick up a loaf for my mother. Good crust, too. Hey, you know, not doughy inside. And so good with butter. Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a little extra slice of meat with this bread, would you? Oh, I made a piece with a lot of fat on it. You know, something nobody else would eat. Maybe something that fell on the floor.
Would you prefer ham and cheese or roast beef?
Roast beef, thank you very much, please.
Lettuce and tomato?
No, not a whole lettuce.
Mustard?
Hey, you got any mayo?
Who the fuck do you think you're playing with, bitch?
Snapshot. I found a profile down the cop shop, Jack.
I'm going to the drugstore for the atropine.
For my good, right?
Why don't you look under the blindfold? Or is that why you covered it? You can't stand to see the damage you caused? I want that atropine.
I'll let Terry go.
Where should I go?
Drugstore tomorrow.
I'm broke.
I blew my last few bucks on the cheesecake. Do you have any money?
You want me to pay for the animal's medicine?
Can I borrow it?
I should have crushed his skull in the first 2 seconds and had it all cleaned up by the time you got home. But instead I talked. And in talk, I squandered it. Talk. No phone calls.
All right.
Say it.
No phone calls.
Okay, bring the police, Terry. I'll do it. One hit's out, he's dead. 2 seconds, that's all it takes. When I see him pull up, one hit he's out, two, he's dead. And I'll be watching every second. It should take 7 minutes to get there. 5 in the store, 7 to get back. Even if he catches the light both ways, I give you 1 extra minute for the uncountable. 7 plus 5 plus 7. 20 minutes.
Don't speed. You might get stopped. Get atropine and something for burns.
Aspirin.
Atropine. I'll write it down.
If you bring the police, Terry, I'll do it. And just like you did. You.
Don't you trust anybody?
Myself. Typical Leo.
Just go.
Bad complicity! Excuse me. Can I say something, please? I just wanted to thank you very much for putting up that money for my medicine. You know, that was very nice of you. Most people wouldn't go that far, but you. You went all out, and I'm all choked up, and I just wanted to thank you from the bottom of my heart. Because it was nice, and it was kind. It was so nice of you. Hey, you wouldn't happen to have an extra cigarette, would you? Or maybe one who smoked halfway?
Menthol filter, all right?
Yeah, thank you very much, please.
Reach your hand out and I'll give it to you.
No thanks. Bad for the lungs.
Would you like a cup of tea? Anything?
17 minutes.
Did you pull the stinger out? Would you like me to get the tweezers?
Please.
Excuse me.
Shut your face, animal.
Can I just say one thing, please?
No.
It's about stings.
Do you want me to put your lights out?
Hey, forget it.
What?
Are you talking to me?
What do you think?
What do I know?
What about stings?
Ain't no stinger in there.
Says who?
A wasp don't leave no stinger. A bee leaves a stinger, then he croaks. But a wasp keeps on stinging.
How do you know that?
I know what I know. A wasp don't sing. And a bird don't sting. They're gonna call you Hammer. One night them hefty lesbies are gonna test your mojo, jump you in your roachy, piss-smelling 6x10, bust your nose, make it flat, spit your teeth in a toilet bowl, and when Bull says get down into the bush, Hammer jumps in the weed smoking dry beaver. Hey, cause you're like me. Do what you gotta do to keep alive. Hey, but don't holler when them hacks get a sudden case of death, cause they don't get involved in petty in-house business. You better keep your ass close to the wall or some cannibal's gonna put a dull screwdriver in your back and nobody's gonna hear nothing when them showers are splashing them radios or blasting them funky tunes and your blood's washing down the drain reminds you of once upon a time in a cozy little house. Me and you, the habit to hold. Rebel.
Here.
There's no stinger.
You pulled it out?
The wasp doesn't leave a stinger.
Hey, you know, the best thing to rubbing with alcohol.
We don't have rubbing alcohol.
Hey, you got any 100-proof vodka or whiskey?
151-proof rum.
That's beautiful. You better let me taste it and make sure it's good first.
Yeah, right. Does it work?
Very well, thanks.
Hey, you're welcome. Anytime! I mean, what the hell are we on a search for if we can't help each other out?
Did Matilda come home?
No.
When did you see her last?
I don't remember.
Was she in heat?
I don't know.
I think we should get her spayed. I can't stand it when she goes off looking for that red tomcat when I'm driving and I see a lump of bloody fur in the road. It's just a possum or a squirrel. Would you mind if I got her spayed?
20 minutes.
Hey! Hey, maybe she stopped for gas.
She's a traitor.
Maybe she ran into traffic. You know, she needs a valve job. Tell her what she broke down.
I'll make sure they put you away.
My dear motherfucker, I'll bite your throat. Hail Mary, full of grace, smoke this moaning bitch.
Marjorie, no! Give me the hammer.
Sorry, don't touch me.
Oh, blessed, I'm not a normal woman. I'm saved.
God damn you.
You killed him for 2 minutes? Oh, who's the atropine?
You can't get it over the counter.
Why not?
You need a doctor's signature.
Did they ask questions?
Why I need it.
What did you answer?
Emergency.
Did they believe you?
How should I know?
What do you think?
I don't know. Did they suggest a substitute antidote?
You didn't say to do that.
You should have figured that.
I told them we live in a farmhouse and have a lot of wasp trouble.
Why did you tell them where we live?
Now what do we do without the antidote?
They said see a doctor or go to the emergency room.
What took you so long?
I ran into Sally in the parking lot. She's getting divorced.
You talked with her?
She wouldn't let go of my arm.
Talking in the parking lot? You did me, bitch! She's gonna hammer me and you're talking in the parking fucking lot?
This isn't for burns, it's for cuts.
That's all they have.
I know they have it.
Then go get it. I'm sick of being the goddamn gopher around here.
A damn moron would have got a substitute antidote.
Then send a damn moron next time, and if you can't find one, you'll do just fine.
I'll apply this for whatever it's worth.
$4.50 to be exact.
Hey, let me chip in. I came my way.
And take off the news to apply the medicine.
Why don't you just fuck him? Maybe that'll make him feel better.
You both make me sick.
Thank you very much.
Shut the fuck up. Put your feet out. Duck your head down. Huh? Slide out.
Okay.
Come on, Pete. Duck your head.
All right, thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a lot better. I like that.
Thanks a lot.
Oh, my God.
Who's that? Hey, Terry! Hey, why'd you do that? Hey, am I ugly?
No.
I am a fucking monster.
Open your eyes.
I'm afraid.
Open them.
How do you open?
Yes.
I can't see. I can't fucking see. Oh, mother of God, I can't see.
I'm sorry.
Tell my baby sorry.
Is there anything I can do?
Yeah. Give me a crown of thorns and finish me off.
Why don't you have the honors? Finish what you start.
What the fuck's going on here, Patty? I prayed for an angel and what's God sent me? A fucking traitor. And fuck you and your bread. And fuck God and fuck them all. You're all gonna burn, baby. One, two, three, burn.
How can I stop the pain?
Give me back my eyes.
What's your name?
Mike.
Mike what?
Matthias.
How many women have you raped and murdered? You don't have to answer it.
Tell them about the pothole crew.
The what?
Tell them why you came here when I don't ride my bike.
Keep it in the phone. Oh.
Sorry.
She said, sure, come on in and use the phone. She was walking around with her robe open. In on a red one. With nothing but John underneath.
Why are you looking at me like that?
I'm not looking in any special way.
I'm using the phone. And she comes strutting in pretty. Okay, she turned me on. I admit it. I'm only a man. God made me that way. All of a sudden, she goes nuts. She starts running around and yelling, Ray pulls the phone out.
Mother of God, do you believe him?
Hey, that's a lie. Let God off me on the fucking spot. I'm talking about the home, Marjorie. No, I'm talking about the grave, my grave.
What grave?
Oh. Oh, I don't hear Marjorie talking now, huh? Hey, Terry comes home and they decide to dig a hole in God and bury me.
Is that true?
Yeah. Between the tomatoes and the flowers with the possums and the dogs. A fucking grave.
That can't be true.
He won't believe me. Well, I let the grave talk.
Is there a grave out there? Ask her. I'm asking you, the one who wanted to make up a story.
I didn't dig it.
See, Patty alive. Bury me alive. Terry and Michael.
All I did was watch it. Marjorie said she would drag him out, throw him in and cover it herself.
Did you get enough justice today? Two eyes enough? Burn a man alive. Is that savage enough?
Not as savage as a human roach forcing your legs apart.
Oh, come on. What'd I do that for? Get some ass? I got poontang on.
I thought your pregnant wife wouldn't let you touch her.
Hey, don't talk about my sick wife like that. Especially you with a sick father in the hospital.
He stole our mail.
I can't live with this woman. First I'm a killer. And then I'm a raper. Now I'm a thief. Hey, what next?
Don't you see what he's doing?
Leave the man alone. Can't you see he's in pain?
Hey, don't say one bad thing about Marjorie. Hey, we all do things we don't mean. And I forgive her everything. All I wanted was a kind word. A little closeness. You know, to forget my troubles. All she wanted was to forget about some guy in New York. Tony.
Tony wrote me, an animal took one of the letters.
He wrote you?
I never answered them.
Why didn't you tell me?
I didn't want to hurt you.
Is that why he came here when he knew I was at work?
Terry, please believe me.
Is that why you changed from jeans to a bathrobe when I brought him here?
I must have been ready for bed.
You're always ready for bed. You do dress loose, you know.
Every time I have a guy over, I have to shout in to see if you're decent.
You parade around this house like it was a centerfold. A man enters the room and you go out statuesque. How you cross your leg at just the right moment. How you butterfly through a room. You're not happy until you've got every man in the room begging for it. And this one did. And now you want to fix him. One man pays for every lech and wolf whistle. You go through men like most women go through Kleenex.
and then you complain about the advances you provoke. The man is blind. Look at what you've done to yourself, to us, to him. Can't you look in blind eyes? Let's see what else you've done.
I use it for work. I cut open boxes in the warehouse.
Boxes, eh?
Yeah.
I thought you didn't have a job.
I mean, before I got employed.
Good, eh?
They're pretty good.
It's so sharp.
Betty!
And strong.
Betty, you there?
The kind of knife they used to gut a deer.
Oh, please.
Your move.
Oh, please.
Don't make your lips tight. You know what you need? A couple of flashes. Here.
No.
And here. Oh, you want it.
Say it. I want it.
Again.
I want it.
Oh, you say that beautiful. Now, where do you like me to touch you?
Nowhere.
I forget.
Nowhere.
Here.
No.
Ah, now I remember. Down there.
Oh, God.
Tell me you love it. Say it.
I love it.
Again.
I love it.
You say that beautiful. Now tell me to cut him off.
I can't say this.
It's your last chance.
You can't make me say it.
You say it. You say it nice and sweet and beautiful, you fucking bug. I cut him off. In your mouth.
Oh, mother, guys, throw the letters, wash the house, get in, get a fucking
house.
You were Betty and Jerry, like Paul was nasty little Martina, Debbie Parks, and so I forget. I screamed. I begged them not to scream. I hated it when they screamed. Every time I do it, it's in the papers. And I get up in the morning, and my wife says, Adam Ripper got another girl last night. I said, don't worry. He don't want you. And she bitches. And I like the door real good so the Reaper can't get in. Come on, tell him to put me in the room. Now locks. I know about locks. I can pick them. Or maybe in a room with nobody else. Or a room with a little radio so I can listen to the ball game. Because I hate the quiet. The dark. I don't care. But the quiet. Please don't let it be quiet. Please don't let it be quiet. Please don't let it be quiet.
I think you should get help.
Okay.
Keep Patricia company.
Won't we be afraid?
No.
What do we say?
Say man is hurt.
Okay.
Say man needs help.
Okay.
Hey, Marjorie!
Yes.
I see your name.
Yes.
I have one big favor.
Yes.
Don't make her put the sirens on.
No, no siren.
And no handcuffs.
No handcuffs.
Thank you. Are you there? Don't leave me alone,
okay? Right here.
Hey, Addie, coming?
Yes.
You don't want to beat me, okay?
No.
Thank you. Hey, Marjorie.
Yes.
Can I wait in the fireplace, please?
Angela.
Who will you show me?
And every evening performance. We have a couple of community leaders here tonight, plus the members of the cast, and we would invite all of you to stay and participate. We've had some really lively discussions about the topic of rape, so feel free to stay. Thank you very much.